Hey folks, this is Gene from Regular Guy Mountain Biking. So look, here's the deal. If getting flat tires is not fun for you, then you might want to listen to this bike chat because we've got some cool information to share with you. Hey folks, this is Gene from Regular Guy Mountain Biking, where we talk about all kinds of fun and cool things that have to do with mountain biking. Tonight we've got a cool guest with us. His name is Adam from CushCore. And he's going to talk about this really cool product they have out right now that's going to help us all save our way from flat tires. So, Adam, welcome to the show. Adam, I do this a lot with my buddy Tony from MTBDropIn. So that's who we got on the show today. And I want to welcome everybody to the show. How are you all doing?
Excellent. Thanks, Gene. Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Gene, thank you yet again.
Oh, no problem. So I am getting a little bit of an internet burp here going on. I'm getting some echo once in a while, so if it looks like, folks, I'm going crazy, I haven't drunk too much coffee or anything. I'm just, internet's not on my side tonight. So here is the deal. Adam from CushCore, they make an insert, and Adam, you can correct me at any time you want so I don't say anything incorrectly, but CushCore makes this really cool insert that goes inside your wheel. And it has some great properties to help, one, eliminate punctures, flat tires, and also something that I haven't heard any of the competition handle, something to do with cornering and helping the ride experience altogether. And I'm going to stop right there because that's about as good as I know it, and I'm going to hand it over to the professional and let Adam explain more about the CushCore product.
Okay. Good job, Gene. Thanks for the introduction.
I'm loving it.
So, you know, a lot of people, when they first see our product, this is what it looks like in a cutaway.
Oh. So, can you hold it up a little higher?
Yeah, people's first reaction is, oh, this is a product to stop flat tires. It's going to stop pinch flats. And it's true. It does that. But honestly, that was the second thing on my mind when we created this product, because there are a lot of other benefits to this that I want to bring to light. So, the basic idea is that it's an engineered foam insert that occupies half the volume of the tire.
Gotcha.
The upper portion of the tire is still filled with air, so you can tune this part underneath the tread patch to whatever pressure you like and feels best. The other part of this is that this thing is designed to apply pressure to the tire sidewalls, so it can stabilize the tire regardless of what air pressure you're using. It also damps the tire sidewall motion. So when the tire is moving up and down normally, it's an inflated tire is like a basketball. It's an inflated rubber ball, and it bounces and deflects off obstacles. And in an ideal world, that tire would act more like a real suspension system with both a spring and a damper. And that's part of an important part of what CushCore does. So it dampens the motion of the tire, and when the tire is normally moving up and down in this part of the travel.
Okay.
But then, of course, when you have a really extreme impact, hard enough to travel all the way down and contact the CushCore directly, it's a firm foam, and it's designed with a specific damping ratio to eliminate the force of those impacts much better than a tire can do alone.
Okay. So when you say dampening, can you relate that to something that we might understand a little bit more and relate that to maybe a front fork or something like that? Is I've heard dampening and how that's like, is there any relationship to that at all? It seems like it has some common similarity there.
Absolutely. Yeah. So my real job, I guess you could say, before CushCore is I'm a suspension engineer.
Oh, geez.
We do suspension modifications for KTM and Husqvarna dirt bikes.
Okay.
And that's where this whole idea started from. I realized that the tire has a tremendous potential for performance advantage that was underutilized. It's acting as a spring, but not a damper. So in your fork, the spring is the air spring or the coil spring that holds up the rider's weight. Damping is the oil flowing through a valve that restricts motion and actually dissipates the energy of the impact. And it's critical that we have both of those systems working together for a proper suspension system. So if your fork didn't have any oil in it, maybe you've experienced that before, it doesn't ride very well. It's just a pogo stick.
Right.
And really, that's what tires are doing right now. So people are used to that feeling. They've learned how to ride with it. And nobody has experienced a properly damped tire before. So when people first get on CushCore and ride it for the first time, it's not a subtle change. It's not something that you have to look for hard. It's an immediate, obvious difference. And generally speaking, people love it.
So let me ask, Tony, where you ride, what's the terrain like? What's the terrain like? And let's send that back to Adam and get an idea, because we're going to get a couple sets of these, both of us, to give these a try. But what could Tony expect when he tells you what his terrain's like?
So do you want me to tell him what my terrain is like?
Yeah, like the trails that you like, the trails that you ride, what are they kind of like? Because they're different than East Coast over here. So I'm just kind of curious what he's going to kind of give you, like, Tony, expect this kind of experience when you try them.
I have a lot of...
Can you move the mic a little closer, Tony? You're low.
How's that, Gene?
Thank you very much.
Okay. So where I ride, it's kind of a lot of rocky features, a lot of like rocks sticking out the ground. So a lot of places where, you know, and there's a lot of drops. So, and there can be a lot of spiky rocks at the bottom. And there's a lot of loose dirt. So technically I like to, you know, I would like lower pressures in my tire so that I can grip, you know, more easily. However, there's rocks. So I hit my rim a heck of a lot as it, you know what I mean, compresses.
Of course. Yeah, so you're facing the traditional tire performance compromise. Everybody knows that. Everybody's trying to run their tire pressure right on the knife edge of between too much and too little. And everybody knows what it feels like when you have too much. The tire's hard, doesn't absorb any obstacles, but at least you don't get a flat, right?
Right.
It's also stable. So in a situation like yours, imagine those sharp rock impacts can be absorbed completely by the foam liner, the CushCore liner, and it will absorb the energy rather than just momentarily holding on to it and then returning it all back to the rider. Okay. So it's a really supple, calm feel when you're going through sharp terrain.
So this is the whole rolling resistance comes in and you pick up speed because, instead of the whole impact going to your rim, you're just going over those rocks more with less resistance. Is that where that more speed comes in? You know how it's.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah. So if with an impact like that, a portion of the force is going contrary to the bike's momentum. So the better, more efficiently we can absorb those impacts, the easier it is for the bike to maintain its forward momentum.
Got it.
The other part about this that I think you'll like, particularly for the slippery sections, is with the CushCore supporting the sidewall of the tire, you don't have stability issues. So you can use a much lower pressure without experiencing tire roll and squirm. So a lot of times, guys will run as low as 15 PSI
really?
In slippery terrain, and you don't have problems with the tire rolling all around and feeling really unpredictable. We have some people who have had a flat tire during a race and successfully finished the event because you can still ride the bike with the CushCore installed.
I never thought of that.
It rides fine. Yeah.
I mean, there's like stuff you're talking about that I wasn't even expecting you to say. I mean, I was expecting we to talk about, it keeps us from getting a flat tire and it's great and everyone hates flats, but that's like secondary, like you said. I wasn't expecting this whole dampening. So that you caught me off guard. Didn't even think that was happening. And I didn't even realize that you're right. You're filling up about half of the tire anyway. So you could technically finish the race, you know, or at least get through, especially if it's an enduro, get to the next stage and get you some time to get prepared. So I wasn't expecting those two.
Yeah, it's happened twice just recently. I mean, we're a relatively new product, but half the UCI downhill pros are already on it. A very large portion of the Enduro World Series pros are on it already. And Jared Graves, one of our early adopters, he got a flat in one of a super rocky section in Madeira, Spain, in the last event. And he was able to finish that test at basically full speed. So it saved his race.
That's
he sent
crazy.
Us an email saying so. And just before that, Brendan Fairclough had a similar situation where he burped a tire or something. We're not exactly sure what happened, But he continued to charge to the finish line and was able to get a 22nd place despite the problem with the tire.
That's crazy. And that kind of answers the next question I was going to ask. Do racers adopt this? Because little history here, Adam. Tony and I get to spend some time talking to Josh Patterson from Bike Radar. Really, right. Really nice guy. And Tony had asked a great question. He's like, you know, well, but the racing, right? What was that? What were you talking about with the weight?
Well, I want it because for me, well, not even just with racing. I mean, like, my battle is to get up the hill. You know what I mean? And like, you know, oh, and then the weight, you know, so it's added weight. So, right. Oh, that was what it was. Okay, so racers, they're weight junkies. You know, right. Everybody trying to save every weight possible as they can. So is this something that's going to turn them off? Or is this something like, you know what I mean? How... I guess that was how applicable is this going to be in the racing industry, basically?
Yeah, it's a great question. But I think we have a good answer for it, too. So, first of all, consider when full suspension mountain bikes first came out. Mm-hmm. Everybody was not willing to pay that weight penalty. And over time, as the designs got better and people got more used to it, they realized that the benefits to momentum were worth that extra weight. And I think we're doing the same thing in tires here. So the tire insert is 250 grams. It's the same as an inner tube. It's light, and we worked really hard to make that thing as light as possible. Mm-hmm. You can also combine it, because you're no longer depending on the tire casing stiffness for stability and impact protection, you can use a lighter weight tire with it without the normal dangers and compromises that you would have with a super lightweight tire.
That's a good point.
So you get that super supple casing tire with low rolling resistance, and you depend on the CushCore for your lateral stability and impact protection.
So have you personally, if you don't mind me asking, Gene, have you personally tried carbon rims? I'm sure you have. Flew down a mountain, you know, a speedy section, and then put the CushCore on, and did you, like, could you tell a difference in the speed? Because I just tried my first pair of carbon rims, and I was just amazed at how you just pick up speed because of how light it was. I literally would go faster. Like, I'm like, it made the bike feel like a little hot rod because of how much speed it would actually pick up in the downhill. Wow. Because of how much, you know, how much weight you're saving, I'm assuming. I'm sure there's more science behind it than that. But, I mean, I tried the exact same bike with aluminum rims and then with carbon rims, and it was just night and day. It felt like a different bike. So am I getting, like, if I, now that I know what I like in terms of carbon rims, am I going to be, still, I don't know, is it going to lose that feel of that light rim, you know?
Well, I think ultimately you're going to have to do a back-to-back test to evaluate it for yourself. However, we do have cross-country pros that are using CushCore because of the reduced rolling resistance. We sent the product to a wheel laboratory in Finland, and they measured it at 3% lower rolling resistance. And the rougher the terrain, the more that benefit will be valuable to you. So if the whole race is climbing up a hill as fast as you can on a dirt road, CushCore is of no benefit. It's not going to help you in that situation. But the more you have real terrain features, rocks or fast corners or anything like that, the more it becomes a benefit. So I think in the end, we're going to see even cross-country riders adopting it after they actually try it. If they can get over that hurdle of worrying about the extra weight, actually try it and experience the speed increase by the other benefits of the product.
What size tires do you guys support right now?
2.1 to 2.5. That fits our standard CushCore. We have 27.5 and 29-inch wheels available currently.
Okay.
We are working on 26, 27.5 plus, cyclocross, and probably other sizes too.
Okay. So this is eventually going to cross the gamut. You're going to use them. You didn't mention fat bike. I'm only curious because one of the issues with mine is when you want to get down to that 5 PSI, 8 PSI, you get the self-steer, right? Because you've got so little air in there. And I just kind of thought, I wonder if this would kind of alleviate some of that because now I've got more stiffness back. I'm just curious if it would do anything for that.
That's a good question. I haven't looked at it closely. Mm-hmm. My main concern with the fat bike is that the volume of the tire is so huge.
Okay.
The insert might weigh too much.
Good point.
But we haven't looked at it closely yet, okay. So we'll get there.
Now, just Tony and I, and whenever we do these shows, we're never out to bash anybody or anyone at all. So without naming other companies, how do you feel your product is better than some of the competitors? Because there's some other tools out there. From what I've read, honestly, I haven't read where they covered what you're talking about around the whole better riding performance. But I'm going to ask that to you because this is more of your vertical right here. How do you feel you guys compare against to some of the other tools out there?
So honestly, I feel like we absolutely slaughter the competition in this market. And there will be reviews comparing all the available products that have come out recently that do similar things. And I think those are gonna demonstrate exactly what I just said.
Gotcha.
We've had quite a bit of feedback from professional race teams that have tried all the different products. And we are the product that all the professional race teams are using right now. So I think it's already been proven.
Gotcha.
But there has yet to be a media publication that's done that test yet. But I know for a fact that Vital MTB is doing one right now. Mm-hmm. I think Pink Bike has one on the way.
Gotcha. Well, Tony and I plan to do it as well. We're looking forward to getting a set of these and giving them a try because now I want to even more because I was only thinking, yay, no flats. But I can't wait to give this a shot now because I want to be able to play with that tire pressure now and be able to maybe drop it a little bit more and even go with a lighter tire than I was expecting to go with and get the benefits of all that. But now what I'm really interested in feeling is that cush, obviously, the whole cush idea and the way it kind of deals with the suspension. That's going to be really interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to hear your feedback.
Oh, yeah.
We did a lot of testing early on. This product has been in development for a couple of years. And we measured the reduction in impact force compared to tubeless. And it cuts it in half, literally. Cuts the impact force in half. But the other side of it is the vibration. So I was talking about sidewall damping. Mm-hmm. And the whole tire system and wheel is vibrating all the time when it's on the trail. So when we measured a standard tubeless system, and then with CushCore installed, mm-hmm. it reduces those vibrations by about 72%.
I didn't think of that either.
The whole bike just feels calm. It just feels like calm and supple and in control.
Now, does it feel stiffer? I don't know how that would work, but is there more stiffness out of, the bike overall feel?
It will feel stiffer side to side. And you'll notice a difference as soon as you squeeze the tire. Like sometimes at the demos, we'll have people grab the side of the tires, like, grab it from this orientation. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then they guess that it has 35 PSI or something, right? And then they push on the top.
Right.
And then it's so soft and supple, and there's only 15 pounds of air in the tire.
Right. See, what I want to try these for eventually, I'd love to give these a shot. Or I'm gonna see if you. I want to see how these work with when you come out with these, a 650 plus tire hardtail, because now you've got that bigger volume of that larger tire, that plus tire, because that's why these things are getting so popular. Because you're getting it's almost like they're bringing hardtails back because of that size tire. You can kind of get just enough suspension, if you will, but you get the kick. Because you don't have the dampening. So that would be one sweet combination of that larger tire with that extra volume. Okay, it might not be a rock garden's dream, but in general, for most riding, you add that bigger tire and the CushCore insert, and that could be pretty sick. I mean, that would really be interesting to see how that would work.
Yeah, I agree. Hmm. But keep in mind that a lot of the benefits that people are looking for with those plus-size tires, CushCore can deliver with a standard size tire.
No, that's true.
So, because you're running that lower pressure, you're getting a larger contact patch. Mm-hmm. And with the plus size tires, they, especially if you're using really low pressure, they have a lot of roll and squirm.
Yeah.
So, that's one of the kind of the side effects of those larger volume tires. But I think we will be able to cure the bounce and squirm that you get from those larger tires. It's definitely on the radar. We're going to do that size next.
Cool.
So can you use sealant? So I'm assuming you can use regular like stands, no tubes with this thing, right?
You got it.
Okay. And what about heard about that slime sealant? Can you use that? Have you guys tested it with that? Or
I haven't tried the slime sealant yet.
Okay.
Yeah, we've had good luck with stands, the Effetto Mariposa, and we're actually testing a brand new one called Plasma from E13. It seems to be good. But yeah, it's a closed cell foam, so it's not affected by sealants. It doesn't absorb sealant at all. One of the other products is an open cell foam. It's the wrong choice for this application. Mm-hmm. And man, ours we have that special shape because they're made in a giant custom made heated aluminum mold. So we can shape it however we want using that manufacturing technique. It's just a lot more expensive.
Gotcha. Well, folks, you definitely want to give these a shout out and take a look at them. Tony and I are going to get a set. We're going to give them a whirl, and we'll have a product review on our channels pretty soon. But there's some things that came out in this conversation that I wasn't expecting, and it's making it sound even okay. Great, look, you know the channel, Adam, Regular Guy Mountain Biking. So there's obviously a reason for a racer to like this, but there's just as much of a reason for a casual rider like us to like this as well. Smoothing out the trails, more reliability, a better rolling resistance. So these are all things that are applicable to anyone that puts their feet on pedals. So this is going to be a lot more fun than I was even expecting. Because, I mean, I was sitting there thinking, great, I got to go beat the crap out of my bike to see if I'm going to get it flat or not. And I'm like, I don't really want to have to test it like that. But it's not the case. I'm even more excited to try these out than I was before.
So do you guys – how is the – does it protect your tire? Like because one of my fears is buying carbon rims, and I'm like, I don't know if I want to make the investment. I'm going to smash them. So would you say there is increased protection?
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. We've done a bunch of testing back to back, and an impact that will destroy an aluminum rim will have no visible impact once the CushCore is installed. So it definitely provides added protection. And we're actually working with several carbon wheel manufacturers right now that want to offer that layer of protection to their customers. So nobody wants to buy those expensive wheels only to have them explode. Right.
Tell me about it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I
want to buy them, but I can't. Yeah, it's.
I mean, shoot. I like carbon rims. It feels great, but I mean, how long am I going to have them? Because I ding the heck out of mine, you know?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, the carbon rims with CushCore it's a really sweet setup.
Nice.
You can kind of get the best of both worlds. And I think if you actually try the product, for most people, the weight issue that's in their head goes away because of all the other benefits. It just makes riding faster and more fun, and people want to keep using it.
That'd be cool. Folks, we are right at that time, and I think we did pretty good. I learned a lot. I learned more than I was even expecting to learn. So this is a good way to go. I'm digging this. Adam, all we can do is thank you for being on the show. We thank you so much. We learned a lot. We both really appreciate you sending some of these for us to give them a whirl. I'm going to speak for myself. I don't like to speak for anybody else. I'm going to say I can't wait to try them out. They sound like they're going to be pretty freaking cool.
Great. Well, I can't wait to hear what you think, Gene. Let me know.
You got it. All right. That's what we got for tonight. Look, it's Memorial Day weekend. What are we doing here doing this? We should be go chilling out someplace. So what are we doing? Hey.
It is what we do on Memorial Day.
Play with our bikes. All right, folks. Hey, again, Adam, thanks for being on the show. Tony, I always love doing these with you. Thank you so much for being on the show with me. Have a great weekend, everybody. Keep the party on the pedals, my friends. And look, we'll catch you later on, everyone. Good night.
Okay. Bye-bye. Take care.
Good night, guys.